An underworld figure known as the Angel of Death has been shot dead at Parramatta, our city's first gangland execution in nearly 6 months. Police say Tarek Gayoub had a long and violent history with organised crime, and tonight officers are searching for those responsible for his murder.
He was nicknamed the Angel of Death, but it was Tarek Ayoub's reputation gained in the underworld that detectives say eventually led to the 29-year-old's demise. His body found early this morning on the driveway of a Parramatta complex with multiple bullet wounds.
Mr. Ayoub certainly lived by the sword and died by the sword.
He was there visiting an associate. On his exit, he met a violent death.
Casings behind to show that they meant business.
I was just asleep. I was woken up by the gunshots, and then I was too scared to get up and see.
It's a bit scary that these things have been happening around our home.
A crime scene today visited by mourning family and friends as the news of Sydney's first gangland hit in nearly 6 months spread. 15 minutes after the shooting and just 5 kilometres down the road, an Audi, the suspected getaway car, set alight in Granville. An almost textbook gangland hit for a man no stranger to Sydney's organised crime network.
He was very well known for a number of violent offences, accessory to murder and firearm offences and drug offences.
Among them, Ayoub previously pleaded guilty to concealing details about the murder of teenager Braden Dillon, who was shot dead as he slept in his Glenfield home. He was also charged after police found a Glock pistol under his couch, along with drugs and cash.
Witnesses saw two men running from the burning Audi to a second getaway car. Residents here say it had been parked up on the street for a number of days before the shooting. Tonight, the manhunt continues for those involved.
Too many suspects, too many motives.
In Parramatta, Madison Scott, Nine News.
And Nine's Madison Scott has an update on the investigation. Maddie, what have you just been told?
Pete, we do know that the Yuguna home of Tarek Ayoub was late this afternoon raided by the Raptor squad, so this is still very much a fluid and ongoing investigation. The 29-year-old had not one but several connections with organised crime gangs, and so police are tonight working around the clock to mitigate and suppress any potential retaliation attacks. And Pete, there are right now 30 investigators working on this case under Strike Force Juno.
All right, Maddie, thank you.